You want to do a review? You literally have to fix the motorcycle before doing it. Ah, seriously though, just a minor issue. Screwed on the mirror to close seat to the gas so it didn't come back. There we go.
Hi, I'm FX, and this is the Suzuki Bandit 650. Be wondering, why I do a review of an 11-year-old motorcycle? Well, I'll tell you, there aren't that many reviews, recent ones at least, of this kind of motorcycle. And even if it's not the exact year date, people who are looking to buy a Bandit 650, well, they might still be helped, because the engine is largely the same, frame is largely the same, everything is largely the same. So, that being said, I'm hoping I can help you with this, and I'm hoping I can help me with this too. This is a very agile motorcycle. It's not the fastest, and especially in early RPMs, up until 7 RPM, this thing doesn't really pull. Which, well, to me is a good thing, because take into account this is my first motorcycle, and the 650 has some power, but nothing overwhelming. However, not being able to have full power, well, full power no one really has from the beginning, but not having that power available until 7,000 RPM, this is actually a very good learner motorcycle in my opinion. And I think that for more than one reason. You see, this doesn't have ABS, which makes it more dangerous, granted, yeah. However, it does allow you to ride, well, more skillfully. I'm not a skilled rider, that's not what I'm saying here. But it does allow you to learn in a different manner. You have to be more careful, but also just a little bit more tactful in the things that you do. And I think that that's probably a good thing, especially for a first motorcycle. Now, just to show you what I'm on about here with the power band. So yeah, as I was saying, high RPMs, that's where it's at. That being said, the brakes do a decent job. I'm not going to say that they're superb, they're not. But they do a decent job, especially the back brake. I've replaced them with Brembo brake pads, not that that matters all that much, to be honest. But I have seen some increase in braking power there. Furthermore, I am on Michelin Pilot Rope 5s. They are excellent. I can't complain about them either. I had Bridgestone Battle Axes before, but they were an older compound of tire, and they were okay, but these give way more grip, way better feeling in the corners. Maybe it's just because they're newer, but I like these a lot. Now, who's this motorcycle for, really? Kinda hard to say, really, because, well, I bought this thing as a beginner motorcycle, but honestly, a 650 is beginning to be a big bike, so people coming off of a 300 or a 125 might think, yeah, maybe it's time to go upwards, and this could be an option. It wouldn't be intimidating, that's what I keep saying. Probably heard this more than once in this review. This bike isn't intimidating. It's as intimidating as you like it to be, because there's so much control over the power. Now, I will be honest, what this thing lacks is more power. Not really, well, sounds kind of ridiculous. Sometimes when you're in a higher gear, just cruising along, which it does admirably, and you want to overtake someone, you always have to shift back at least one gear, mostly two, just to get that pickup, you know, that here we go. And I do kind of lack that a little bit. That's why I am looking to a larger CC class bike that has a little bit more torque, that can get you out of those situations a little bit easier. It's basically an excuse to be lazy. Oh, so I don't have to shift. Yeah, well, sort of. Another point of contention with this motorcycle is its seat. Again, it's okay. It's decent. It's not great. And that is, I think, going to be the general consensus of this motorcycle. It does everything you want it to do. It's just not exceptional in anything. It's a very enjoyable motorcycle to ride. As I said, it's agile. However, don't be mistaken, it isn't the lightest of all motorcycles, especially in this class. See, I'm even taking my hands off the wheel because it gives me that much confidence to take it in the corner. But, it weighs 215 to 290 kilograms, depending on where you look. And that is okay, especially for me, given that I'm 1.94 meters and I weigh north of 105 kilograms. Let's keep it at that, shall we? For me, I'm quite a bulky character. So for me, this is not that heavy. I'm thinking about buying a Z1000SX that weighs about 20 to 25 kilograms more, and even that wouldn't be much of a problem to pick up. God forbid that it fell. But keep that in mind, Kawasaki Z650 weighs a whole lot less than this. So does a lot of 750s and a lot of 900s. Actually have shaven off a lot of weight in the last decade. Now, let's address the obvious elephant. Not the obvious elephant, an elephant is always obvious. Let's address the elephant in the room here, shall we? Yes, it does have some scratches, some dings in it, because I've laid it down twice. And that was kind of my own fault, really, because I was too inexperienced the first time, and the second time, well, it was oil on the road, not much I could do about it. That being said, and this is a very positive point, this motorcycle got back up and just continued riding, and I swear, the first time that it fell, it had some damage. I had it fixed. It cost me about 400 euros to fix all of the essential things. But it still rode. Second time I fell, well, I could see the humor in it.
What the
and I took it back up, placed myself on the motorcycle, and off it went. Even my mechanic says that it's nearly impossible to destroy these things. And I'm inclined to agree. You know, the Suzuki SV650, it has like low RPM assist or something like that. You don't need that here, I think. Just let me wait until this car passes so I can prove it to you. Five kilometers an hour, hand off the gas, motorcycle rides itself. I don't know what you call that, but I call that low RPM assist. Alright, so I've talked about the power delivery, almost forgot to tell you how much power it actually has. Depending on where you look, although the differences are very minor, it's 84 or 85 horsepower. I'm sure this poor thing has lost a couple by now, but well, that goes for me too, I think. So, we're even. For a 650, you know you have the Z650 of Kawasaki, you have the CBF600, all of those motorcycles, except for the CBR, have less power than this one. Now, they're all different engines, so the power delivery is different. But top end power? This thing has them beat. I'm sure that isn't going to be useful in a day-to-day situation, but I thought I'd let you know. The sound on it is a typical 4-in-line, but I have a Leovinch exhaust on it. I didn't place it on there myself, it was already on there when I bought it, but it does make quite the difference. Distance-wise, this motorcycle actually gets you quite far, about 300 kilometers on a 19-liter tank. Well, quite far might be an overstatement, but I think that's a respectable number.
It's also very good at waiting in front of a light. Unique quality, that.
The bars vibrate quite a lot. The rest of the motorcycle is fine, but I've tried a lot of, well, three different sorts of mirrors, and it's quite hard to see anything out of them once you get going at a decent speed. So, take that for what it is. I'm up in the highest gear now. Let me show you what it's like to just pull off. Nothing, 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 nothing. Now we're getting to go. So yeah, how to describe this motorcycle briefly, concisely? For me personally, because I've ridden on it for so long, I've had it for 3 years, it's quite hard, because to me it does all the things, just not all great. But I think this would be ideal as a sort of canyon carver. No roads that aren't highways, but you can still go fast, long sweeping corners. Then again, what motorcycle isn't good for doing those things, really? But suppose you want a utility vehicle. So I bought this for 2,700 euros, 8,000 kilometers on it, and well, it was brand new basically. But yeah, throw some bags on it and you're set. Very bumpy road this, and I do feel it, but I am a heavy person, so the suspension is doing a decent job, all things considering. And you can probably hear it in my voice how bumpy the road actually is. It doesn't hurt or anything, and the suspension can only do so much, but I think it does a good job. Anyway, that's Belgian roads for you. So, in conclusion, if you're thinking about getting this motorcycle, know that it's not perfect, but it's really good. And if it's a 600 or a 650 you want, you can't go wrong with this thing, especially if you're looking for something in the naked class.
That's it for today. Thank you for watching. Leave a like if you liked it. Leave a comment if you have something to say. And I will see you in the next one.